Heat sinks are critical components in electrical and mechanical devices that reduce temperature and improve performance. Hello, I'm Armin. Welcome to my channel. In this video, you'll learn how to model a heat sink in COMSOL Multiphysics using the Conjugate heat transfer physics interface. Additionally, I'll guide you on how to add radiation from the heat sink into the ambient environment. Before we dive in, let me briefly explain the details of this model. Let's get started. Heat sinks are passive heat exchangers that transfer heat generated by an electronic or mechanical device to a fluid medium, typically air or liquid, to prevent overheating. Heat sinks are commonly made of materials with high thermal conductivity, such as aluminum and copper, to efficiently dissipate heat. The heat sink absorbs heat from the heat source, such as a microprocessor or power transistor, and disperses it into the surrounding environment. This process is enhanced by increasing surface area, using fins, and employing forced convection methods such as fans or liquid cooling. Heat sinks have various applications across different industries. This model includes two physics interfaces, heat transfer and fluid flow. The block surrounding the heat sink represents the environmental air, where I apply laminar flow. Heat is transferred from the heat sink to the surrounding air, so I use the heat transfer interface for both domains. Air enters from one side with a defined velocity, while the other side serves as outlets. Since I want to analyze the equilibrium temperature, I will use a stationary study. Finally, we will visualize the velocity and temperature distribution through contour plots. Let's get started. I will start by clicking on Model Wizard. Since the geometry is 3D, I'll select 3D space. In the Select Physics window, I'll expand the heat transfer section, and under Conjugate Heat Transfer, choose laminar flow, as the airflow speed is insignificant. I'll then click Add and proceed by clicking Study. In the Study window, I'll select Stationary, as I want to analyze the temperature distribution under steady state conditions. Finally, I'll click Done to move forward. Now, let's begin modeling by creating the geometry. I'll use a heatsink from COMSOL's built-in library. To do this, I'll navigate to Geometry and click on Part Library. Here, you can find a variety of pre-built geometries tailored for different physics interfaces. I'll expand the heat transfer section and select one of the heatsinks. After clicking Go to Geometry, the heatsink is added to the geometry window. Now that we have the heatsink in the geometry, we can customize its design using the input parameters. Here, we can modify various properties such as the number of fins, base dimensions, and more. Once the design is finalized, I'll click on Build All Objects, and the heatsink will appear in the graphics window. Apart from the heatsink geometry, we also need a fluid domain. To create this, I'll use a block from the primitive section in the Geometry tab. In the Settings window for the block, I'll define its dimensions, for instance, 0.4 meters by 0.2 meters by 0.1 meters. Then, I'll click on Build All Objects to generate the block. Next, we need to position this block so that the heatsink is centered inside it. I'll adjust the block's position by modifying the coordinates, for example setting the X and Y positions to minus 0.17 and minus 0.7 respectively. This positioning is correct. To confirm, I'll make the geometry transparent, and now we can see that the heatsink is perfectly centered within the box. The next step is defining the materials. To do this, I'll right-click on Materials and select Add Material from Library. In the built-in Materials library, we can choose any material we need for the simulation. Since the domain is air, I'll select Air and click Add to Component. Similarly, the heatsink is made of aluminum, so I'll choose aluminum and add it to the component as well. Once done, I'll close the Materials window. Now I need to assign the materials to the respective domains. First, I'll assign aluminum to the heatsink. I'll press Ctrl and the keys to select all objects and then deselect the block to choose only the heatsink. Next, I'll assign air to the block. To do this, I'll clear all selections and select only the block domain. This completes the material assignment. Now it's time to prepare the physics interfaces. Let's start with heat transfer in solids and fluids. For this physics interface, we need to specify the solid and fluid domains before adding boundary conditions. By default, all domains are set as solid, so I'll manually select the fluid domain. This block represents the fluid domain, so I'll select it. As you can see, the fluid domain is now correctly assigned, and the solid domain is overridden by the heatsink. Next, I'll set up the heat flux for the heatsink. The heatsink is exposed to a 40-watt heat source, so I'll navigate to the Physics tab, expand Boundaries, and select Heat Flux. Then, I'll choose the bottom surface of the heatsink to apply the heat flux. In the Flux Type option, I'll change it from General Inward Heat Flux to Heat Rate and specify a value of 40 watts. This sets the heat source for the simulation. Now, let's move on to the laminar flow physics. In this step, I only need to assign the fluid domain, so I'll clear all domain selections and select the block. You can see the red cross next to the material icon has now disappeared, confirming that the setup is correct. Next, I'll define the inlet flow for the fluid. I'll navigate to the Physics tab, expand Boundaries, and select Inlet. Then, I'll choose the inlet surface and specify a velocity of 2 meters per second. Of course, for the inlet boundary, we can select different options such as mass flow or pressure instead of velocity. The remaining surfaces will serve as the outlet. I'll expand Boundaries, select Outlet, and assign all other surfaces. The outlet pressure is set to 0 gauges by default, so no further changes are needed. The inlet flow also has a specific temperature, which must be defined in the heat transfer physics. To do this, I'll right-click on Heat Transfer, find Inflow in the menu, and assign it to the inlet surface. This ensures the inflow boundary is consistent with the inlet. I won't change the default inlet temperature here, but it can be modified if needed. For the outlet, I'll assign outflow, as it automatically calculates the temperature at the outlet since we don't know it in advance. Now, COMSOL calculates the temperature of the air at the outlets based on the heat transfer through the fluid domain. In the multiphysics section, all couplings are automatically set up, so no additional changes are necessary. Next, I'll proceed to the Mesh tab and click Build All to generate the mesh. I haven't modified the default element size, and the mesh is successfully generated without any issues. Ensure that the mesh accurately captures the geometry around critical areas, such as sharp edges, corners, and narrow gaps. Finally, it's time to solve the simulation. I'll navigate to the Study tab and click Compute to start the solution process. The solution is complete, so now let's investigate the temperature distribution. The temperature is displayed in Kelvin by default, but I will change it to Celsius in the expression section and click Plot to apply the change. The temperature is approximately 65 degrees Celsius, and by enabling the maximum and minimum markers, we can see the extreme values on the heatsink. We can also analyze the velocity and temperature of the fluid. The pressure increases at the face of the fins due to the airflow obstruction. Currently, heat transfer in this model occurs solely through convection, as the fluid is only set to account for convective heat transfer. To make the simulation more realistic, we need to include radiation heat transfer between the heatsink and the environment. To add radiation, I'll navigate to the Physics tab and, under the Boundaries section, select Surface to Ambient Radiation. I will then choose all surfaces of the heatsink except for the bottom surface and the air domain. The ambient temperature is set to 293 Kelvin, and I need to specify the surface emissivity for aluminum. I'll change the emissivity setting from material option to user defined and set it to 0.2 for aluminum. Now, I will recompute the solution after ensuring everything is correctly selected. I forgot to deselect the bottom surface of the air domain. After solving this problem again, we observed that the temperature had decreased due to the addition of radiation. The solution is complete. The temperature has decreased slightly due to the inclusion of radiation effects. Let's take a look at the other results. This concludes the tutorial. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the content, please like the video and subscribe to my channel for more tutorials.